Hello everyone, this is Ahmed Dan of AhmedDan.com. Today I'll have another episode of Toronto Vlog video, and I'm in the west part of the town, so I'll be walking from close to Humber View Loop to close to Islington Avenue along Lakeshore Boulevard. So I'm looking at to walk somewhere between 45 minutes or so, and I'm not sure how far or where this is going to take me, but along the way we'll see lots of stores, nice views, and Lakeshore Village, lots of tall condos. So this street runs parallel to the lake, and if you take a look on your left, for example right now, then you can see the lake a little bit here. It's a very nice view on the left side, especially if you look, if you have the lake view and leave one of the tall condos. So the format of today's video is going to be, I'm going to be talking once in a while, and I'll talk about various things. So today is very windy, the temperature is about 0 to minus 3, 4 degrees. But possibly the wind noise is going to interrupt. So I'm not sure how much you can hear me, or my voice is going to be very clear. But I'm hoping it's going to be clear. I'm using additional audio. So I don't use my camera's own audio system, so I have a separate audio system, and then I attach audio later on. So this place is Mimico, and there is a huge condo community. So you can see lots of tall condos surrounding this place. So the street I'm walking on is Lakeshore Blvd West, and here another glimpse of the lake. So in summer, this area, there are lots of activities. There's a park and sailing park. So due to the wind, it feels much colder than the actual temperature. So although it's minus 3, but it feels like minus 10, 15. And it's a cloudy day. It rained a little bit before. And I saw some flurries, but not any snow today. And you can see they are still building more condos. and some of the condos have unique designs. The 501 streetcar runs all the way up to the long branch on Lakeshore Avenue. So today is Monday and it's a holiday due to the Boxing Day, which fell in the weekend. So there's a streetcar coming, which is 501. And constructions everywhere. See some condos on the other side of the street. And I'll just show you up here. So the name of this street is Shore Bridge Street. So about 15-20 years ago, this place, there's nothing, no condos. And there used to be lots of motels here, but all of them are gone. And then, you know, a new community started to build. There is a park coming up, and the street we are getting is Marine Parade Drive. the name of the park is Humber Bay Park East. So I'll show you a little bit around here. A little long red light, but time is up. So this is the park I was referring to, and you can see that Humber Bay shores. So if you look at this object, this is actually a red light camera. So whenever you know you're beating the red light, it takes pictures and sends you tickets to your home, and everything is automated. So you're just going to see a traffic violation ticket in the mail, and you have to just pay. You don't lose any points for these types of tickets. Looks like there's a small shopping complex right here. And we are going to pass the Humber River. So just, you know, stop for a few seconds and I'll show you the river. So here's the Humber River, if I'm not mistaken, and you can see a nice white bridge, which is a very beautiful bridge to walk on. And in the summer, actually lots of people come here just to walk along the lake and enjoy the nice views. Looks like there's another kind of shopping plaza right here. And there's a bike trail or walking trail throughout this area, which goes a long way. I believe they go to Mississauga or even farther. So looks like the wind a little bit died down, so I have a feeling you can hear me better now than before. So here's another glimpse of the area we just passed. This is the west side of the park, Humber Bay Park West. And you can see that there are farmers market. And just a glimpse of this side. Wind started again, so it got very windy. So this is the, this is what is like by the lake. You get lots of wind. It's very good for summer, but in the winter it gets very colder because of the wind. So the street in front is Legion Street. So the condos in front of me, these are actually a bit older. So I have seen them already before, let's say 15, 20 years ago. But the condos we passed, those are comparatively newer. But the walk, the area we are walking through is still lots of, we're going to see lots of stores and coffee shops, small businesses in front of us. And still, the area is not fully developed yet, so I believe there will be a lot more condos in the future in the area ahead of us. So this is another condo complex. So it's a little bit quiet area. You are only, let's say, 20 minutes from downtown Toronto, but still it feels like a different world. More peaceful life here. There are lots of houses along the street. Some of them are very old, some of them are new. So this area is called Etobicoke. So it's right before Mississauga. So Mississauga is still a part of Greater Toronto, but it's not part of Toronto City. But right now we are in Etobicoke, which is still part of Toronto City. Another condo complex. So once I start walking, it doesn't feel when time passes by. And this is my third walking video. I already have released two other walking videos, and on this channel I have more than 700 videos as of this recording. And I don't have any single topic of video, so you'll find a variety of videos on this channel. And there are no affiliated links to sell anything or to make money off you. But if you'd like to support me, then there's a link which is the support me link, and you can visit that link in the description box below. So we are seeing some apartments here. And some of them are very old. So as you can see, these look like much older. Once in a while you'll see the 5-1 streetcar passing by. So you have another big apartment complex here. And actually the people on the side, they have the lake view. Lots of stores on the other side. So for the past couple of weeks, I don't remember seeing the sun out. It's always cloudy, either raining or snowing a little bit, but it's not heavy snow yet. We had a little bit of snow on Christmas Eve, which you'll be able to see in my the Christmas Day walk video. We're looking at flower shops, coffee shops, Subway on the other side. I brought my gloves today, but I'm not wearing them. It's much easier to hold a camera if I don't have gloves, and still my fingers are freezing. So you have a charge here. You'll find there are lots of travel videos as well, and there are lots of business class flight reviews videos. So if you're interested, you can check them out. So looks like this small coffee shop. Then we have a grocery store. And the name of the street is Superior Avenue. So if you can see, whenever a streetcar stops to get off passengers, the cars have to stop. You can see that all the cars are stopped because people are getting in and getting out. And if you do the violation, or if you, you know, still keep going, then you're gonna get a ticket. So it looks like there is something here. Lots of artwork and graffiti. So not sure what is this, whether it's a playground or something else. Like the name of this store, Broke Billionaires. So the lake is right on our left side. It's just steps from here. Summerhill Road, rather small road. You can see the lake. So you can see that there are numbers next to the rental website. So what it is that you can go to the website and input the number and you'll be able to do a virtual tour of the apartment you're going to rent. So that way you can see how it looks even before renting the apartment. Very convenient and practical. Hillside Avenue, small road. So you'll see dedicated lanes for bikes. Environment friendly. So it looks like right now, not many stores, but lots of houses and apartments. But once we pass a certain point, we'll see lots of stores again on both sides. Something very cool. So the whole walking video is just one recording. The moment I turned on the camera and then when I'm going to turn off the camera, it's non-stop recording. No rest, no turning off the camera. So you're just, you know, looking at full walk of that period, which is the video. More apartments by the lake, and all these apartments have somehow the lake or water view or lakeshore attached to their names. Simmons Street and Miles Road on the other side. Lake Crescent, smaller street. These houses, they have actually their own access to the lake, so they have a small backyard or dock by the water. It's like having a private beach. So this one looks like Polish something, I'm not sure what is this. Actually, the Consulate General of Poland. So I'm surprised that they're not in the city. They chose to make the consulate in this area by the lake, which is nice though. So these houses look like they were comparatively newer, but if you look on the right, those houses are very old. So the roadside scene is going to change soon. We're going to see lots of stores and businesses on both sides of the street. And I think I can walk up to Lakeshore Boulevard. Sorry, Lakeshore Avenue. So far I have walked about 40 minutes or so. So by the time I hit Lakeshore, it should be about 50 minutes to an hour, which should be good enough for this episode of On What Video. So Royal York is coming up. It's a big street going north-south. So this is Royal York Road. some nice view there. A few snow flurries here and there, might snow later on, but so far it's still okay. So you can have a good glimpse of the lake right here. Although it's a lake, but when you look at it, it looks like an ocean. You cannot see the other side.
What's going on?
Lake again. Sand Beach Road, and there's a small parkette there, nice view. So it looks like we've passed houses. Now businesses start on both sides, starting with McDonald's on the right. First street. I'm seeing people again. There's a restaurant, but the restaurants are closed to go in. You can just check out. Lots of stores are closed due to the COVID. From here, it's gonna be 3rd, 4th, 5th street, but I'm not sure how far it goes like that. Looks like there's a hotel, which I haven't noticed before. It could be a new hotel. And on the other side we have lots of stores. The big guy's little coffee shop. Nice name. Fifth Street. course. There's the nice Vespa bike. So it looks like we have a specific park specific store. The red color is very catchy with the white contrast. Sixth Street. We are close to Islington Station, which I thought I was going to make it, and looks like I made it. There's some artwork here. So Islington Street is coming up. And I'm going to go for another possibly 5 minutes. Right there. Which is 7th Street on the other side. Boarding on and off the streetcar.
Please wear your mask.
Face covering live in the TTC. Lots of stores, some of them are unique. Possibly family run businesses. I might do another video in the future from here to, you know, going all the way possibly Mississauga, because this road goes a long way. I'm not sure where does it end. I'm going to turn right at the next light, and you can see some townhouses here, and actually long before this place was empty. It was just a playing field, there's nothing here. Let's try to get this walk light. I kind of cross in the middle. So here's a view of the Lakeshore, and we entered a local a residential area, so you can see lots of townhouses and apartments and condos in front. So we walked close to 1 hour non-stop. Although my goal was to walk up to Islington, but I passed it. And this is where I'm going to end the video, but let me just show you around a little bit here. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you shortly.